Hey everyone, welcome to this video. If you're watching this video when it's coming out, March 2021, then April 1st is a few days away. No, this isn't an April Fool's Day joke, why would I tell you then? Anyways, April 1st is actually quite a significant date in Indian history. And to know about that, we have to go back to 1921 and visit a session of the Indian National Congress in the city of Machilipatnam to find a Telugu man, Pingali Venkaiah, working hard on making a flag for India at the request of Mahatma Gandhi. Pingali Venkaiah is known as the designer of the Indian flag, and this design from that day 100 years ago would evolve into the recognizable flag India flies today. But how did the flag movement even start? How did Pingali Venkaiah and Mahatma Gandhi meet? What happened to Gandhi's spinning wheel? And what happened to Pingali Venkaiah? Most importantly, what do chapatis have to do with this? Let's learn all about that and more in this episode of The Nature Thread. Actually, this episode will be split into two parts because there's so much to cover. So if you enjoy this part, make sure to subscribe so you don't miss the rest of the story. Pingali Venkaiah was born near Machilipatnam in Andhra Pradesh to Pingali Hanumanthrayudu and Venkata Ratnamma on August 2, 1876. As a teenager, he was a supporter of Mahatma Gandhi and had the opportunity to meet him when he was serving the British Army in the South African War around the turn of the century. However, his family wasn't supportive of him going to South Africa and he wasn't allowed inside the house after he returned. After he started searching for a job though, his parents called him back since his sisters were getting married and moving away. During this period, he also spent time researching farming and studied Sanskrit, Urdu, and Japanese in the Anglo-Vedic school in Lahore. Meanwhile, discussions about a national flag heated up around 1905 when Viceroy Curzon decided to partition the province of Bengal on the basis of religion. Before this point, India did have a flag, but it was a British ensign, like Canada or Australia or basically any British colony, with a solid coloured background, a Union Jack canton and a symbol to represent a colony, India's being a star. This flag was introduced in the decades following the 1857 First War of Independence to represent Britain's imperial rule on India. In fact, the first flags of a united India were used in the war. For example, many of the protesters in Meerut, where the uprising started, adopted a flag designed by Bahadur Shah Zafar, with a green background and a lotus and a chapati. I'll leave a link to an article about the connection between chapatis and the uprising in the description if you're interested. Anyways, back to the 1900s. In 1905, one of the first proposals came from Sister Nivedita, an Irish follower of Swami Vivekananda. She had started a school in Kolkata, the Nivedita Girls' School, where her students stitched her flag design, which she would present to the Indian National Congress in 1906. This flag is quite interesting. First of all, it's square-shaped and the background is red, while all the symbols are yellow. The edges are lined with 108 oil lamps and in the center is the motto Vande Mataram, written in Bengali, meaning I salute you motherland. In the middle of these two words is the Vajra, a symbol of the Hindu god Indra. This flag didn't end up catching on with the movement at the time though, and you can kind of tell since it's so different from today's flag, unlike most of the other flags that would come in the following decades, which kind of look like a prototype of the current flag, such as the next flag. This flag is a tricolor of green, yellow, and red. The green band has 8 half-open lotuses on it, representing the 8 provinces of India at the time. The yellow band has the words Vande Mataram again, this time in the Devanagari script, and the red band has a sun and moon. It was designed by Sachindra Prasad Bose and Sukumar Mitra. They presented it to Sir Surendranath Banerjee, who called for a meeting with leaders from all the districts of Bengal for it to be approved. On 7th August 1906, during an anti-Bengal partition rally, this flag was hoisted by Sir Surendranath Banerjee in Kolkata's Parsi Bagan Square. India's next flag was hoisted in 1907 and it was similar to the previous flag. The significance of this flag though is that it was hoisted all the way in Stuttgart, Germany at the 1907 International Socialist Congress. It was presented by Madame Bhikaji Kama, an Indian freedom fighter and women's rights activist who also gave a speech about it. This flag was also known as the Saptarishi or Seven Sages flag because of the 7 stars on the top stripe. Saptarishi is also the Sanskrit name for the Big Dipper, part of the Ursa Major constellation, by the way. So that's all for this part of the video. We'll continue from 1916 when Pingali Venkaiah joins the flag story in the next part. Sorry I haven't uploaded in so long. I'll try to make more videos soon. You can expect part 2 sometime in the next week or two. If it's released by the time you're watching, you can watch it by clicking it on the screen. You can also comment any feedback. For example, do you like this new virtual background style? Also, we're very close to 100 subs and the 1-year anniversary of my first video. So I'll be doing a Q&A sometime in April. So if you enjoyed, you can subscribe and also like and share the video. But anyways, until the next video, bye and let's keep learning.